Okay, this is a quick review of the Rover Pro Cut 50 self-propelled mulch and catch lawnmower. This particular model has the a Chinese-made, I believe, overhead valve engine. It's 196 cc's, 9.1 pounds of torque, which converts about 5.5 horsepower. Nice unit. Yeah. Comes with a mulch plug for mulching. It has a clutch housing in there. It has a separate high mount air filter plus the paste filter down near the carburetor. It also has unique to Rover, I believe, is this mulch mowing and catch mowing function. So when you want to mulch, loosen this and you'll see that you push down on the handle and the front wheels will drop down, and that flattens the deck out, and supposedly it helps blow the lawn clipping straight down into the lawn. To reverse that, it's the normal catcher mowing, loosen that, send it back and tighten it up. So in here we have a, underneath it's four blade unit with a belt well protected in there. You can just see it. Goes back to the drive unit with the clutch, so there's a cork clutch inside there that can be adjusted. There's an adapter there to plug your hose into for cleaning purposes. We'll fire it up. Okay, up here there's no throttle on this, so it's basically you start it and it's going and that's it. So it's a case of pull that into start it. That's your drive, your clutch, starter, 12 height adjustments. It's a pretty heavy unit, but you would expect that for a 5.5 horsepower mower. I'm not sure there's a self-propelled or push mower with a, certainly there's plenty of 5.5 and 5 horsepower engines, and even 910s or 196 engines, but none of them have 9.1 foot pounds of torque. So it's a fair unit. So catches, solid catcher. You've got metal plates, nice big air vents, unlike the Hondas with their bags, which tend to restrict airflow in certain wet conditions. You've got nice big airflow. I've mown in rain, and certainly got plenty of power to throw all the clippings right into the back of the catcher. Does a good job. So it's a simple case. Demonstration of the speed of this thing. It's only got the single speed. Some argue that it's might be a little bit far for some people, but I guess essentially it's a commercial unit. This is the 20-inch version. There's a 22-inch version with the same motor. I opted for the 20-inch. Figured there's more power per square inch with the smaller cutting deck, and I don't need a bigger deck. So I'll just give you an example of the speed and the do one run with the catcher on and one run with the mulch plug-in. Now I've shot with the mulch plug in. Nice and fine. Very fine clipping. Mulch plug in. That. And again. Any longer grass than that, but there's certainly not much visible grass in there. Does a nice job, I think. I don't think it's too fast, and it's a good mower. Highly recommended for $650 in Australia. I really can't see why you would. It's hard to compare with the Honda mowers. Problem with the Honda, I tried a Honda out here and it was wet. Thing with the Honda is it's got a point like that's got a full width chute. Throw the grass, and the Honda just had this tiny little chute here and it just blocked up with the thick grass, especially when it was wet. So for the money, I can't see how you go past this. The ProCut 50 or the ProCut 560 in the 22 inch wide version. It's a good unit. As far as I can tell, and I am biased, that looks pretty bloody good to me. So I think the right tools, still hard work, but with the right tools you can do a good job. Thanks for watching my DVDs, and check out my other videos. Thank you.